States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Do we have a thing on here, do we?
Yep, I got it.
Okay. Alrighty, well, we're gonna call a meeting to order. Okay, approve the agenda.
I'll make a motion to approve the agenda.
Motion by Eric, can I have a second?
I'll second.
Second by Bruce, all in favor?
Aye.
Motion carries. Approve the minutes on February 13th.
The only question I had, Paul, was on, when you changed the agenda for tomorrow, did anything in the minutes here need to be changed? Because I don't know.
The only thing that was changed tomorrow is just a, it's just a levy.
Okay.
There is no hearing.
Okay, I just wanted to make sure that was.
Yeah.
Alright. I'll make a motion, we approve the minutes as printed there.
First.
Second.
Second by Eric, all in favor?
Aye.
Okay, motion carries. Doesn't look like we have any public concerns. No one's here. We're gonna drop down and approve claims, so we can get started on those to start with.
Well, the book, when I looked at it, and if I got the right page, I got 302, 528, 23, and drainage is 22, 23, even, 00. Is that the number you got?
That number I got, yeah.
Okay, we have a motion and a sec, do I get a second by Dave? All in favor?
Aye.
Motion carries. Alrighty. I'll let Chris come and work that with us. Okay, Paul, you're up.
Morning.
Morning.
We have several orders of business this morning, but the first is, I'm finally glad to approve hiring for a laborer position for Secondary Roads Department. I hired and accepted an offer from Robert Wolf. He's from Renwick, Iowa. He'll begin work March 8th. And he'll start at per contract, the union rate per contract, which in this case is $20.81 for the apprentice. And then after 6 months, he'll roll into new contract, and I don't know what that is, but that will be by contract as he goes on.
Is that like W-O-L-F?
Yep. It's just a big bad wolf.
Yeah.
No E, no anything. I keep trying to spell it with an E, but I refer back
well,
to his.
Sometimes.
I refer back to his resume, and it's Robert Wolf, W-O-L-F.
Yeah,
hauling cattle, huh?
Well, he's hauling a little everything now. He's all under contract over east, and he gave notice, and they had scheduled stuff through like the 5th for him. And then that's where, then he's going to take a 2-day breather or something and start for us.
He'd be a good man.
I sat out with Paul, and we went through the top few interviews, and I agree with Paul. He sounds like he's a good candidate.
We had a big pool, and this time between ice storms and some of the other things, we ended up interviewing 7. We generally don't interview more than 3 to 4. We had good candidates out of the interviews, overwhelmingly, as they walked out. We said, that'd be a good guy, that'd be a good guy, that'd be a good guy. Oh, shoot. So it was a very difficult choice, and we had a big pool to work with, and we're very fortunate.
Can I get a motion to that?
I'll make a motion to Harry.
Motion by Dave.
I'll second it.
Second by Bruce. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Motion carries.
Second order of business is to approve work in the county and right of way for North Central Iowa Services, Ms. Mitch Fridolfsson, for directional board underground primary across 550 Gosh Park Road. It's right across from a Cretex or, just call it Humboldt Concrete Products, people know where that's at, going east. And he's gonna take underground primary clear back to his lot that's just north of the park, just east, just west of the East Branch River out there.
Okay, can I get a motion to that effect?
Hey, Paul, did he do this yet?
I don't know.
You don't know?
I don't know, I didn't.
But you did ask everybody and.
I know he's up against a weather deadline.
Yeah, and it was nice, did someone, and, you know, Paul mentioned this, and I said that, did someone mention, this is not, we don't want this to precedent, if you're thinking, get this permit applied for ahead of time, and then give yourself some timeframe, did someone mention that to him?
Yeah.
If not, I will.
What I mentioned is if he couldn't get at it and be sure that he was done and gone before the weather, don't even try it.
Right.
And the last I knew, Wednesday afternoon, he wasn't anywhere in sight.
Just, you know, he says, fine, we know the weather, we don't wanna hold somebody else.
He didn't wanna get all of us in trouble, so I think he recognized that, don't know if he got there or not.
Maybe not then.
Well, it sounds like everyone else asked the same question, 'cause that's what I said to Paul.
Right, and so that's the thing, we don't wanna stop progress, but we don't wanna not.
We have in the past, when you got weather issues like that, we do make.
Right, but, you know, it's.
And this is directional board, as opposed.
Not like digging up a road.
No, I know, it's not making a big huge ditch.
He might have trouble out there, that's all sand.
And rock.
Yeah.
It might cave off.
Maybe decided to wait till he had more time, but otherwise, I'd say approve the permit.
So I got a motion from Eric.
Approve it.
I'll second.
Second by Dave, all in favor?
Aye.
Motion carries. Okay, next item.
He'll need a signature eventually. Another one that is, approve of the IDOT permit and Humboldt County working the right of way permit from Goldfield Telephone Company for fiber placement along 169 at 240th and 250th Streets and west along 250th Street to Rolling Hills. Our part in the DOT permit is where they cross 240th and 250th. I didn't even give you that permit, it's more or less much the same as ours. The DOT requires us to sign off when there's anything touching right of ways out there. So, where they're boring underneath 240th and 250th, that's part of the DOT permit, and then they wanna turn west on the south right of way limits, and go to Rolling Hills. And that isn't for anything soon, but they have to get all this to the DOT, and they wanna get at it as soon as they can in the spring. So this is, something that's, gonna be done as early as they can, but they still have to get to the DOT and back with approval yet.
Okay.
They got approval from the city, now they're seeking it from us, for the DOT side, and from us to work along the south right of way along 250th Street. And I believe every, yeah, okay, Bruce, I was just looking, I thought I copied the whole works, but some.
And they got permission from the DOT out there?
Excuse me?
They have got permission from the DOT out there?
No, they haven't, they're asking, there's two permits, I have the DOT permit that I didn't copy, that we are working on two permits with this motion, is to approve and sign off that we don't have any issues with 240th and 250th. The city's already done that, just like you would with Dakota City on these matters, and,
I make a motion to approve it.
Motion by Dave, second.
Second.
Second by Bruce, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. All done.
Just a second, I gotta see who's, Humboldt supervisor, that's where I thought it was. I'm gonna figure out where you have to sign here yet, oh, here it is.
Chairman of the board?
No, this can be me, I think, very good, I'll look at it before.
All right.
This is the original, the other one for, the one for Goldfield. Otherwise, last week in the breaking the ocean, we got those signs, you remember we did a sign order, where we're in up to $10,000 of reimbursement from the DOT, where we replaced about 200 stop aheads and some 60 railroad round warning signs. We spent a couple of days on those and most of them are done. Hopefully, we can finish those off this week. We can get the documentations back to the DOT in an effort to get an approval or to get our money refunded in the same fiscal year. So while we had the weather, we actually pulled people out of trucks hauling rock to, we had three crews running, six guys, and some of the blades were out, thus we had a short crew hauling rock some of the days last week. Tomorrow morning is a letting, that is 10 o'clock here at the board. And I hope to see you there for that. I hope we got it warm because what we did change on the amended agenda is we have already had hearings on these projects as secondary roads because we had hearings with the five-year plan last year. So formally, we don't have to have hearings again. And we have a letting tomorrow, and if we have a successful clean bid and then we're in a position that we can award, I would suggest that we award tomorrow as opposed to waiting. We have some snafus coming with federal permitting, and if we can get this turned, then we don't have to deal with those. If we can't, we will, and that's just the way it is. So.
Okay.
Here's Mr. Fridolfsson's permit, too. Otherwise, I think I'm done with signatures.
Hey, Ruth.
Otherwise, snow removal Friday wasn't too successful. Saturday, I think we got everything punched out. The highways cleaned up fairly well. And there's just hit and miss snow out on the paved surfaces, but everything's been run without much wind blowing afterwards. So we should have, if there's issues out there on a gravel or something, then I'm not aware of it at all.
Get some sunshine, it'll melt them off.
Well, we cut them down, and it's as soft as it was Friday and even Saturday. It's a tough deal to cut too much, so we'll have some slop. The roads will be slop definitely once temperature gets up and until if they have a good crown on them and they're not ponding anything, then they'll dry off pretty quick. If they're flat and rutted, then they'll be sloppy until we can get them maintained. Very good.
Okay.
Thanks.
Thanks, Paul. Alrighty, now we're coming in a little early, but we can still move into drainage and get set up. Need a motion to go into drainage.
Motion
by Dave.
Second.
Second by Eric. All in favor of moving into drainage?
Aye.
Aye.
Motion carried. We are in drainage.
Okay, Trish.
Perfect. Carl, are we back yet?
You know, is it a home game tomorrow night? Should I text Carl to see if his tickets are available?
You know, it is.
I think it is
a home game.
The last game.
Yeah.
Oklahoma State.
State.
I think it's the last home game.
Yeah.
I think he's going
to
be back.
To be able to tell him how.
Tell him the weather's going to be bad. Where's his ticket?
Yeah. Wow.
Don't upset you, but is there any chance we can get your tickets early? We want to sell them.
Yeah. Raffle them off.
Carl had me.
Wouldn't you know?
Say this gift to you. Just a little information from.
Where's Chris today?
He's in DC.
Oh.
At a NACO conference. Representing the state.
Wow.
Yeah.
Guess you let anyone be the day, huh?
Well, if there's any, if you have any idea that he wouldn't have been there, he'll be able to show you a tablet of notes that you'll shake your head and say, Carl, you were at the meeting.
Probably, and we'll probably all get a copy of it.
Cause he is thorough.
Yeah, he's.
Make sure it brings back information. Good, yeah, thorough report.
I'm supposed to call Rick. Jim Rasmussen after, he's on his way to Nebraska and didn't think that he'd be able to.
Well, attend this one.
Attend the meeting, but.
Okay.
Do you have new copies or we get our old copies?
I get new copies.
Okay, I figured you would.
Yep, just, and I plan on that just cause it's.
Easier, right?
Yeah, just, yeah, you guys don't have to go.
I do, I have the original.
Oh.
I have the official.
Yeah, oops, sorry.
Maybe.
Aren't you special?
No, not really.
Hey, we're right on time.
We'll try and keep that up.
We're trying. We're trying. Well, I don't know if that clock's right.
That clock is slow, I got 8:51.
Yeah, it's going backwards again. Yeah, it just loses time.
We're gonna put that in the budget to get two new batteries.
I think we need a clock.
I think we need a whole new clock cause we put new batteries in it. I think that's from the 1940s.
First one they made like that.
Okay, let's go ahead and get started.
Okay.
I got 8:52.
What I just gave you is, I think that's the next one.
Yep.
Okay.
125.
125.
Yep. We got word that there was tiling done that would bring land into DD-125. We had an individual volunteer to fly their drone over and get us pictures of what's going on and I have pictures with me. From that flight. Bottom line on the whole thing is, if you look at that drawing in the back, the area in blue is what that tiling brought in.
Okay.
I believe there's only two landowners involved. Gansett Trust, and then Rod Nave has just a little bit, 4 acres down at the bottom of the blue. So we're filing this report to get that area officially brought in so that when we submit the reclassification, which is very close, we can have it all in there and just be done with it. I talked to Reese's, if you look way over to the right, just south of the road there, there's a piece that is Reese's. I guess it isn't labeled here, but it's, they have like 3 acres.
In that corner?
Yeah, just right up in the corner of their field. I talked to Terry and Mark Reese. Their situation is that most of that is in the wetland program. They do not want to drain any more of their land into this project. So we just left their 3 acres in there that's right in the corner of the field. And
okay.
That's it. Otherwise, it's just the area in blue. So there was some concern from Terry Reese on whether perforated tile was used to make the connection. The tiling they did was outletted across Reese's ground without permission, and they're just concerned that if they use perforated tile, that could affect their wetland program. So I just got a note to myself to talk to Gary Nave and see if he knows. Worst case, they have to replace that 50 or 60 feet with some non-perforated. But at any rate, the connection brought this blue area into the district. Total's like 76 acres, about. 76.14, to be exact. So, basic procedure with this would be to accept the report and set a hearing date on the annexation. This is a 40-day requirement. I have not looked ahead. If you get into, just into April, you should be okay. And I'm not sure, you don't have anything probably that far out scheduled, do you?
No, I don't think so. So what are you looking at?
Let's see, that's 333. I'll go to second. Monday.
You've got to go.
We looked at 10 of April.
Six pages, seven pages.
Yeah, six would do you, this is a good way to look at that.
Yeah.
Days, and yeah, okay, yeah. A week on each turn, yeah.
You're looking at the...
Perhaps the 10th of April?
Yeah, it would be 40 days, wouldn't it?
Yeah, okay. I don't know.
That's fine, I would think.
Won't be a lot of notice given here, with only two landowners involved in the annexation. That helps the situation, so.
I have a question. You said that if we accept the report, you can do that with the...
Perforated tile.
Perforated tile.
Yeah, because that's something we can work out.
Regardless.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
I just wanted to ask.
Good question.
So when did you think, April?
10th.
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 Few days extra.
Say 9 o'clock, just in case.
That was a nod, yes, I think, at 9 o'clock.
Can I get a motion?
I'll make a motion to accept the...
I'll second that.
Report and set the April 10th at 9 a.m.
Okay, we have that. A second from Eric, all in favor?
Aye. That's number 125 at 9.
Okay.
Look at what I put up this morning. I need to step back and look at the sheets I put up. That is about as crooked as I can get it.
Oh, it was hanging off, I put it back up.
Oh!
It was me!
Oh, okay. I use that reusable tape and it doesn't hold real well.
Okay. Alrighty, we got one done. Now we got a few minutes before 86.
Let me just give you an update. Can I do that?
Yeah, give us information.
Okay.
That's fine.
On DD6, we've got the plant and specs ready, and what I'm gonna ask you for is to officially set the bid date on that. I've got a date tentatively in the specs, which can easily be changed if for some reason you don't wanna do that. I've separated the project into the main tile and branch B. They're completely independent with the design we're doing. They don't share any length of tile at all. It'll just be cleaner for construction and cleaner for future assessments. I actually, in the specs, have it worded so that we'll look at the main separately and decide who you wanna award to there, and we'll decide the main, branch B separately and decide who you wanna give that to. I thought that would open it up to more contractors.
Yeah, smaller guys could do the...
There you go, yeah. Still a good-sized job, but not huge. Still need quite a bit of bonding, but...
Yeah. Do you have in the specs that every tile connection is photographed with GPS?
I don't have the wording photographed in there. It's that we see it.
We want it photographed and GPS marked.
Yes, good point. I think I got the GPS, but I don't think I have the photograph. I will definitely get there.
Just to refresh my memory, the six, where are we talking about?
Just north and west of Thor a little bit.
Yeah. It actually crosses the
Thor block down.
Yeah, yeah.
And the B is the one straight north of the bulkhead.
Yeah, right, yes.
Branch B does.
So yeah, it's just north. No, it's not in any of these. Okay, I was thinking I had a map to show you, but no. So. The drawing on top, on the right, way at the upper right corner, that's the start of the ditch, and that's 1 mile west of Thor, and then north on the gravel road, about a mile and a half. So, yeah. I'm gonna talk about that six later too, and that's...
I noticed you had that down.
Yep, so. A lot of interest. We've had a lot of calls. I look for Nels Peterson's to hit it hard. I look for Denver to hit it hard. I don't remember who else has already been asking questions about it, but a lot of interest.
What I understand, my son's in the construction business, and he says people are really hungry.
Yeah.
They've been bidding jobs, and jobs been really getting bid low.
We had a bid last week, well, 2 weeks ago, and up in Spirit Lake, and there were 13 bidders on an open ditch. I was amazed. We're not expecting near that many here, but for some reason that one just generated all kind of interest.
I think a lot of people got more work done this winter than they expected, so they're...
I think that's a lot of it. Yeah.
Had a good winter.
Yep.
Over here to have addressed that.
I see.
I had a question for you. I'm trying to think of what it is, but it has more to do with DD number 4. We'll talk about that when we get there.
Okay. Vern Wechter's been calling me a couple of times.
The Odison?
Yeah, the Odison deal. We were able to download LiDAR elevations. One of our engineers took, in an hour and a half, he got it downloaded, got it on the right relationship with land in the outside there, and figured out the quantities to do a waterway. And I mentioned to Vern, he was looking for options, and I'd hate if this has to go to court to do anything. Vern has an option that he could sign a petition for a waterway improvement if he wants to. I don't know if that's something he'll think about or not. A lot of them do not want the tile, very expensive. Rick and I talked about that here a while back. But worst case, the waterway could become a district waterway with a petition. So we'll see where it goes. I'm going to talk a little bit with the Kossuth board. I'm on the agenda next week with them on something else. And I just want to review that a little bit with them.
So is that, do you have pictures of that from... like way back when that was a waterway then?
Not as defined as I would have thought. Yeah, we downloaded like 6 or 7 years of pictures trying to look at what showed the best.
They don't go back any further than that?
We got...
How far back did you go?
1930.
That's pretty good
difference. Yeah, 30 to 35, somewhere in that range. There was kind of a range there that there was just one set of photos for. You can see a path that the water would follow, but it moved a little bit from year to year. That's telling me it's pretty flat out there.
Yeah.
And my engineer that downloaded the elevation information said there's no defined waterway shows on the contours. Hmm. But it's
that's what my visual observation was too.
Yeah.
You know, that's the thing. It never was technically a waterway.
Not a district.
Not
waterway.
Really. Not district. Not
yeah.
Private. Not nothing.
Yeah.
But the point is that the water did flow there.
Yes, if it builds up enough, it would flow
it
even
does,
now.
It is going to flow there, but it just isn't a structured, recorded
there
event.
You go. There you go.
So.
Yes.
Okay.
I can't tell. Is this light going? There. The light's coming in. I couldn't tell if the light was on in that mic.
Go ahead and get started with DD6 now.
Okay. I've kind of explained how we're looking at it. A lot of interest in the job. I didn't bring the new estimates with me, but with the final sizing and final design, we've got those quantities all in the spec book. I have tentatively put down March 20th at 9:45. Because you have a bid letting.
At 9.
Yeah.
DD3.
Yeah, 9.
That's a hearing.
Yeah, you have hearing at nine and the bid at 9:30.
9:30.
So I was looking at that same day. That'll give the contractors 3 weeks, because we'll make a notice.
This previously, because I already put a note in.
Okay, we probably.
Did we put number six?
Number six at 9:45, I have.
Oh, okay. I didn't think there'd been action.
For a hearing?
Well, maybe.
For the bid.
That's not number three.
I had bid letting wrote down.
Okay. So maybe you took the action and I just, yeah.
I have it written down too, but.
Well, that's.
What do you have for drainage district number three on the?
Well, let's reaffirm that, just make sure.
9:00 for the hearing and 9:30 for the bid.
9:30 for number three.
Yeah, have that. And then we're asking for number six for the set bid date.
For 9:45, yeah, same day.
Yep, that should work.
We need a hearing on six and then a bid letting, or?
No, had the hearing already a while back.
I thought so.
Yep, so just a bid letting.
Okay, let's just have a formal motion to that effect, make sure.
I would make a motion to set 9:45 on Monday, March 20th for the bid date on drainage district number six.
Okay, I have a first.
A second.
A second by Dave, all in favor?
I have a question before you vote there. Are you gonna have enough time between taking a bid letting on 9:30 for three and 9:45 for?
There, yeah, I think so. I think we can read through the bids on three in 5 or 10 minutes.
That's fine, I just wanted to make sure you were gonna press.
And there's no second bid on an open ditch where we wanna give them extra time to do anything.
Works for me, if it works for you.
There's not a lot of bid items, so I think I can check the math in a very short time too, so. But no, that's a very good question.
Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Motion carries.
Pressure's gonna be on you, Rick.
Not a problem. We can do this. Definitely can do this.
Ruth, are you here for which one?
I've got two.
You got two, okay.
I need to get those.
We're in the 9:15?
Yeah, we're still a little bit ahead of time.
Okay, I'm gonna get a copy.
I'm gonna get some coffee, I gotta quit percolating.
We'll just take a short recess till, no, I think I just can declare that. Yeah, shut her off for a little bit.
I'll grab a few copies of these too.
Beans are pouring, Bruce.